All right, so I haven't made an update video on SKSE 64 for quite a while, and that's because there has been absolutely no good news. It wasn't looking so good. We thought it wasn't even going to come out. This is good news, but it's obviously not the best news that we could have gotten. SKSE 64 2.0.0 alpha has been released today, which, again, is fantastic news, but it's not the full SKSE, so we're gonna have to wait for that one. So essentially, this is a version of the script extender where mod authors can play around with it, port their mods over, see how things work, and it's also not completely stable. Not everything works as of yet. There are a lot of issues with it. It's, again, in alpha, so this is not something you should download and install. That will completely break your fucking game, and I really do not suggest doing it. If you wanna test out some mods, see if they work, that is totally fine, but please do not use this on any saves that you plan on continuing to use. Just feel free to test, but this is more for the mod authors. You should definitely wait until there's a proper release. But this is good news because we finally have a glimmer of hope that SKSE is indeed coming out for Skyrim Special Edition. Skyrim Special Edition's mod community has been a little stale recently because there is no SKSE support, which means there is no Sky UI and there is no mod configuration menu. There's no mods like Immersive HUD. So there's a lot of stuff that's missing from Skyrim Special Edition that a lot of people love to have on their games, which is a huge reason why a lot of people haven't switched over as of yet. But this is available for you to download if you want to go ahead and test it out. It's very simple. It's the same as every other SKSE. I actually already have it installed, but I'll go ahead and overwrite it so that I can show you guys this. Let's go ahead and just show this in a folder. As you can see, if we go ahead and just extract it, which I've also already got it extracted, we go ahead and open it up. It's the same as every other SKSE that we're used to. So it's on its way. It's making progress, and I'm excited to see when we'll see a full release, or at least a release that mod users can use and use mods with. Because as of right now, it's not suggested that you download this again. They say it on their page itself, alpha build, modders only, do not ask for support. Right now, there's a lot of mods, at least most of the mods. Currently, actually, none of the mods work for me. Some people do say that some mods like Immersive HUD do work. Sky UI 5.1, I believe it is, works along with the mod configuration menu, and some mods do indeed still have their mod configuration menu files, so they still work, but none of them work for me. It could be because I'm using Mod Organizer, and that would totally be understandable. But this is fantastic news because at a certain point, it was seeming like there was no hope for SKSE 64 coming out at all for Skyrim Special Edition. So the fact that there's an alpha now is great to see. So hopefully that means that a proper release is at least a few months away, and we'll start seeing mods roll out for SKSE, which I'm pretty excited for because I just want to be able to completely move over to Skyrim Special Edition. But anyways, I honestly just hope that this video brought a little bit of hope, I guess, for you guys that SKSE is coming for Skyrim Special Edition. A lot of people lost hope, a lot of people were upset, but you guys do have to keep in mind that these mod authors, they're doing it for free, and they have lives as well and real jobs. So you gotta remember that, gotta give them props for at least getting an alpha out, and hopefully we'll see a full release sometime in the near future. Anyways guys, until next time, this is Epoxy, signing off.